Good day everyone, GarageKing here, and today I have a dreaded problem. I have an intermittent check engine light. It is a P0420. You can see there, it's showing up on the scanner right there. And if we pan back to the interior quick, you can see there is no check engine light because it's just popping up randomly. So, awful. Anyway, with this code, it could be a few things. It could be the catalytic converter, okay? It could be the O2 sensor, or both. Or it could even be an exhaust leak. Now pay attention to the exhaust leak. That's the one I greened on the bottom there because you know what guys? I think this one's just a simple exhaust leak and I'm gonna show you how to fix it. Now I know you're curious, so let's take a quick look under the hood and I'll show you where the oxygen sensors are. Now also 2013 to 2017 are all the same. I saw some videos, they must have been older ones because they had a ton of sensors. And you know what? On this vehicle, there is only two sensors, so it's actually quite easy. Now, if we pan around here, you can see here is, I guess, the exhaust manifold. You can see here's one sensor up on top. Now, very easy to get to. We're going to have to pan underneath the vehicle. You can see here's the flange at the front of the vehicle. Okay, now we follow it all the way back and you can see there is the second oxygen sensor. And you know what? If you keep following the exhaust, you will find another catalytic converter behind that, but there's no more oxygen sensors. So that's it. So we only have two to worry about. All right, now hold your horses. Before we start ripping out O2 sensors and stuff like that, let's check for leaks. So once we go underneath here, I can see there is an exhaust leak. Well, actually, I can't see it, but I can hear it. And I hope you can hear it as well now. I'm playing the footage and you can actually hear the engine, but there is a leak. And what that little rubber thing that I'm using in my hand is, it's actually attached to a stethoscope. And I was trying to get the leak showing a little bit better through the video, but it's just not working. But anyway, you gotta trust me on this. There is a leak. So the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna go to our scanner and we're gonna take a look at our voltages for our O2 sensors. All right, so we're back in the vehicle. I have the scanner here, taking a look, and just wanna show you guys here. Take a look at this. Look at the secondary voltage on that O2 sensor. It is showing zero. The vehicle's running, so we got no voltage. The first one is showing, it's just over 3 volts, so that's good. But secondary, we have absolutely no voltage. It's at zero and it just flickered there. So we got a little bit of a problem. So maybe our catalytic converter is just too cold. So let's take our gun, take a little look under here, and there you can see. I don't like those temperatures. They're not looking high enough. It's barely at 100 degrees centigrade. So that's just not hot enough. So let's go back here and rev up the vehicle and see if we can really heat it up and get some voltage out of this sensor. So I'm revving the vehicle up here and let me just scroll here so you can actually see the temperature. There you go. You can see the temperature. It is really climbing. The first cat is almost at 1,000 degrees. Second one now, it's at just over 300 degrees Fahrenheit. So we should be getting some type of a voltage. Now, if we go back to our sensors, we can see, yes, we are getting a little bit of a voltage. So what that's telling me is that exhaust leak, I think, is our problem. I think it's our exhaust leak, guys. So let's get underneath here and let's start taking everything apart. So first things first, we need our impact gun and we're going to try to take these two bolts off. And yeah, they do look like they're quite, they're just quite tight. So that is not a good thing, but let's keep at it for a little bit and see what we can do. Okay, so it's working now that I got the tool up to 150, but I don't like to run the tool at 150 all the time because it reduces the life of the tool, but running the tool at 150 was enough to get this left side bolt out. I'm gonna have to clean up these bolts because the threads aren't the greatest on them anymore, but the problem is this right side here, it is just not coming, and that's even at the gun maxed out 150. I mean, that's all my compressor can do. I can't do anymore. So all that's left for me to do, I guess, is, yeah, take Bandit's advice here and let's get out the torch and let's see what we can do because the bolt is actually twisting and the gun is gonna snap it off. So I don't wanna snap it off. So best thing to do is use some heat and we'll just take it off with some heat. Usually using the torch, anyone that works in the garage knows that whenever they heat up bolts and stuff like that, they usually come out pretty good. Now, not everyone has a torch. You can try using a benzene torch if you don't have an oxyacetylene, but anyway, that's what I did. Enough rambling. At the end of the day, you can see I was able to get the bolt out by using the torch. So that's great. And now we can pull this thing apart and see actually why it's leaking because there's gotta be something wrong here. And I don't know why. The funny thing is there was two bolts that looked like they were new or newer. So someone was in here doing something. I don't know what, but anyway, let's inspect it and let's see what's going on. So I'm gonna take this little centerpiece out here, and in order to do it, I actually have to just cut these bolts off. So we're just gonna cut these bolts off, and then what we can do is take out the center tube.
And there we go, one bolt head is off.
I can feel those on my arm, so let's get some better gloves for this job. There we go.
There we go, so we have it off. Now, if we pan in here, I'm quite disappointed. I have no idea why someone would have welded these nuts to the flange. Makes no sense to me. I don't know why anyone would have done this. So I'm just gonna have to cut those off and then we're just gonna clean it up a little bit here. So anyway, you can see I've cut the bolts off now. I'm just cleaning up the flange. So that's good. And obviously make sure you wear ear protection, eye protection, and wear something so you're not breathing in all the fine particles, when doing this, just not good for your lungs. So this seal was pretty tight here. So I actually used a big pair of pliers just to wiggle it off. And you can see here, I'm wiggling it off and there I have it off. So now here, surprise, surprise, take a look at this. So if we look at this right here, you can see it's actually dented. I have no idea how that happened, but this thing is supposed to be totally circular and it's not. It's got a flat spot. So that's gotta be where it's leaking. I mean, it has to be. But let's put on our investigative caps and look at the seal. Let's look for some proof. So we can see it's silver all the way around, but look at this black mark right here. You can see this black is where the exhaust gases were actually escaping. So there's our proof. We had a bad exhaust leak. So time to fix up the flange. So now that we have our flange fixed, what we're going to do is we're just going to move over to the vise. Metric 10 by 125 is the thread pitch of the bolts. So we're just going to clean up the bolts. And then once we have the two bolts cleaned up, what we're going to do is we're going to pop back underneath the vehicle. And same thing, we just want to clean up these bolt holes a little bit. So we're going to do that. There we go. All right, so enough of that. So if you need new gaskets, and I suggest you do, 31630 is the front, that's a Walker part, and the back one is 31374, so that's the back one. So now that you can see it's all cleaned up, what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna put on some of this spider patch stuff. It's just like a liquid sort of sealer. You can get it at any hardware store. I'm just gonna put that on to help the seals out a little bit. Okay, and now that that looks like it's all nice and sealed up, what we're gonna do is we're just gonna push on the new donut. That's what they call them, the exhaust donut. So there you go. You can see I'm just pushing it on. A little bit's gonna squish out there, and this will hold it nicely in place, and it'll seal it. Now let's go to the other side, and what I'm gonna do is the same thing on this side. So putting this exhaust goop on actually serves two purposes. Firstly, it seals. That's the most important part, so you don't get a leak. So it actually seals really well. And then second, it'll actually hold everything in place. So this way, if you're looking up and you saw on the other side how I went and I pushed that donut piece up, it'll actually hold everything in place when you're installing it. So it just makes life a little bit easier. And I did decide to install a new centerpiece. It didn't actually cost that much, so I figured, you know, why not? It's just a centerpiece, and the flanges were actually pretty thin on it. So anyway, this way I was just afraid. I didn't want to do the whole job again. So I won't drag out this video by showing you how I put the centerpiece on. I mean, obviously, if you took it off, you're going to know how to put it on. It's just a new one I put on. The most important thing, hopefully you get out of this video, was this was all that was needed to repair the intermittent check engine light. I didn't even have to replace an oxygen sensor, so I didn't have to do it. All it was a leak that was causing the light to come on, and the light never came back on, so it was a success. Now, as far as tools go, anytime you're doing exhaust, I say you need something that'll generate some heat. So if you don't have one of these little benzene torches, then definitely oxyacetylene helps. Other than that, GarageKing over and out. If you have any questions, please let me know. Hopefully you enjoyed the video.